Hi there, this is Josie Davis from Ask Josie Davis, the advice column. I received an email from somebody named Nicole in Charlotte, North Carolina, who is dealing with her mother, grandmother having dementia. And I just have to say that my dad has dementia right now, so I definitely relate. I would like to share my advice. Do you know you're watching an advice column? In case you don't, this is Ask Josie Davis, the advice column. But maybe you clicked on this. Oops, a message just came in. Ignore that. Okay, so this is an advice column. So I don't know if you clicked on it by accident or not. Whatever. Welcome, either way. If anyone has advice, you can email me. Pardon that loud motorcycle. Quickly driving away, but not quick enough. Go! So back to the dementia, Nicole, I completely relate. Like I said, my dad has it, and I can share my advice or my experience and my sort of opinion on things with you and see if it helps. I know you said she thought that you were her niece the other day. And, you know, whatever. I mean, they say all sorts of things. They don't know what year it is. Different things happen. It gets better sometimes and it gets worse. And then, you know, I for some reason, I adjusted to it really, really well. And the way I think I adjusted to it well was that I was concerned. I made it more about him than myself. And from the email that I heard, it sounds like you are more concerned about how upset you are, and you also did say that you didn't want to cry in front of her, which I understand. That's nice. But a lot of it was more about like you being upset, and you know, and that's completely understandable. What I want to share with you, what really helped me was to make her time easier and make her time pleasant. And you know, my dad doesn't make sense a lot of the time, and that's okay. And I don't react, because that makes them feel really badly when you react like, what do you mean the dog is purple and the sky of yellow bananas? What does that mean? You know, you just you know they're trying to say something. It's not making any sense, and you can ask questions, but I found it helpful to not react like, whoa, that made no sense whatsoever. And I noticed that pretty much everyone around me was reacting like, what are you saying? Which, of course, that's not helpful. That just freaks them out. So I'm sorry that you're going through this. I'm sorry she's going through this. But it will make it a much nicer time for her. And for you too, if you can accept that this is not a wonderful thing, but if you can accept that it is what it is, it's part of life, and just try and make her time happier. And just have a nice time with her. And that's it. And don't try and control it and fix it. Honestly, I think that's the best advice I can give you. I had a lot of serenity with my situation with my dad, and I when it first happened, you know, I really was able to have serenity pretty quickly. I mean, it was a month of hell, but I was able to bring him serenity, really, and have that serenity at the moment and the calmness with him. So that's what I'm sharing with you and with anyone else dealing with that. So if you need anything further, you guys can email me at askjosiedavis@gmail.com if you would like me to talk more about this subject or talk about something like your love life, which tends to be common, or your health, or any sort of relationship, whatever. I will try my best to help you guys. Even if I give you the wrong advice, just take it, run! I'm kidding. No, just do what you want with it. But, you know, find sort of what feels right in your heart if I'm giving you the right sort of, you know, sharing my experience and it's sort of good advice for you or not. All right, so email me at askjosiedavis@gmail.com and I will get back to more of these as soon as possible. Adios, and thanks for watching. That was very strange. Okay, goodbye.